And welcome to our channel MedStudy. Today in this video we are going to see about history taking and examination in gynecology, which is one of the very important practical aspect. So let's get started. The first point is demographic data, which includes name, age, address, marital status, parity and social status of the patient. Then coming to chief complaints and HOPI. Chief complaints should be taken in a chronological orders, and HOPI should elaborate each and every chief complaint in detail, that is history of present illness. Now coming to menstrual history, first is menarche, that is the age of onset of menses. We have to know the regularity, duration and length of the cycle, amount of bleeding, any history of passage of clots and first day of last menstrual period, that is LMP. Now coming to obstetric history, we have to inquire for the previous obstetric events in the form of year, pregnancy events, method of delivery, puerperium, whether it was eventful or not, baby weight, sex, duration of breastfeeding and contraception used or not. Obstetric history can be summarized as number of living children, out of which boys are how many, girls are how many, health status of the child, immunization and last childbirth occurred on. Now coming to past history, we have to inquire past medical as well as past surgical history. In family history, malignancy of breast, colon, ovary or endometrium is often related. Tubercular affection of any family member can give a clue to diagnosis of pelvic tuberculosis. Now coming to personal history, it includes diet, appetite, sleep, bowel and bladder habits, addiction, use of contraception and allergies. Now coming to examination. It is divided into two points. The first is general and systemic examination and second is gynecological examination. Gynecological examination further includes breast examination, abdominal examination and pelvic examination. In general examination, we have to look for the build. Too obese or too thin relates to endocrinopathy and related menstrual abnormality. Nutrition, stature including development of secondary sexual character, pallor, icterus, cyanosis, edema, clubbing and vitals including pulse, BP, respiratory rate and temperature. Continuing with general and systemic examination, in neck we have to look for palpation of thyroid gland and lymph nodes. In systemic examination, we have to do a brief systemic examination of all the systems including cardiovascular, respiratory, gastrointestinal and CNS. Now coming to gynecological examination, the first is breast examination. It should be done routinely, especially in a woman above age of 30, to detect any breast pathology. The six-step examination of breast includes inspection with arms at her side. Second is inspection with arms raised above the head. Third is inspection with arms at waist. Fourth is palpation of axillary nodes. Fifth is palpation of supraclavicular nodes. And sixth is palpation of outer half of breast. Now coming to second point in gynecological examination, which is abdominal examination. First is inspection. We have to look for shape, scar. We have to look for the condition of umbilicus, movement with breathing, lump if present. Then coming to palpation, we have to palpate for tenderness, guarding and rigidity. We have to look for palpable lump as an ascites due to tuberculosis, ovarian malignancy and Meek syndrome. Then comes percussion. And the last point is auscultation. You have to auscultate for peristalsis and if any bruit are heard. Now coming to last point in gynecological examination, that is pelvic examination. It includes inspection of external genitalia, vaginal examination, which includes inspection of cervix and vaginal wall, palpation of vagina and vaginal cervix by digital examination, and bimanual examination of pelvic organs. Then comes rectal examination and rectovaginal examination. This concludes with gynecological history and clinical examination. So I hope you liked the video. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will never miss an update. Thank you.